Hello, my name is Ross Elliott and I'm going to be showing you how to use the door keyboard. So to start her up, use a USB and just plug it into the side of your laptop or computer. So the first thing I'm going to show you to do is how to map controls to the faders on the keyboard. And so to do that is Command L within Logic. I'm then going to hover over the and then a slow build up. So the next thing I'm going to be showing you how to map in is resonance to it. So we pick the resonance. Resonance on this, so we'll try it on to the other side to see if there's more of a coming through. The next thing we are looking to map is the cutoff. Stabby sort of sound, but then that long hellscape is the same. Right, and then the next one we're going to look at is to add. So we're going to look at controlling the rate of the LFO within LFO 2. I personally want to change the panning within it, within LFO 2. So you should. Number 4, so it's going to be quite different sounds. So. Got that? Drum rhythms, playing them live using the keyboard. To ensure that every single note is on time. So to do so, I'm just going to highlight. And then we will just search through. Okay, so that's the right one. So that's quantizing it to the 16th note. That's the break beat. The next beat I'm going to show you is the shuffle rhythm. I'm going to play that at 120 BPM. Possibly the 32nd note. Yeah, that is the one that we would like. So next one I'm going to be doing is the 6/8 swing rhythm. I'm going to play that at a tempo of 70. Feel that this tempo is a little too slow, so I'm just going to move it up perhaps to 80. We'll just see what this sounds like. It's too fast now, so we'll just move this back down to 60. There we go. now we're going to again quantize this to the right note. Move to the 64th note. Okay, I'm happy with that. And the last one we're going to look at is the 7/8 straight beat. I'm going to do this around 100 tempo. Listening.